Welcome everyone to Pirate TV. I'm Devin Daniels.
And I'm Adam Howell.
For this last episode, we're gonna switch it up a little.
We're gonna have each of our crew members come out in pairs to switch as anchors.
Yeah, like that idea will work.
Well, we'll see how the princess plays worked out as well.
All right, well, the play went really well. Both classes had to do their own plays. And I think the second graders really enjoyed it. The first play was called The Princess and the Princess. My fourth block did that one. And I think both the princesses, Ashley Williams and Paige Platt, played the parts quite well. One was a mean princess and one was a very nice princess. But all the students did really well in the play. I particularly liked the royal guards, the soldiers, the queen, the ladies in waiting. The royal wise person added a lot at the end. Shout out to Patrick Myers, our senior who did that. And our stagehand, Ray Bagwell, did a great job. And then our other play was called Twice Upon a Time. We had three really creepy witches. We had a lot of princesses, Snow White, Cinderella, Beauty, the Princess and the Pea, Sleeping Beauty. They did a great job. We had some funny dwarves, particularly Stupid, did a great job. We had Abraca and Dabra, who did great. So I just think everybody did their parts really well, and I like how both classes pulled together as an ensemble and worked together. We really enjoyed it.
Hey, it's your boy, too, coming to you live from the Pirate News Station. You know, I wish I was a princess like them, don't you? Well, I could see why you probably win the most camera shy superlative. Speaking of that, let's cut to that piece.
Our next Picassos are Macy Meyer, Maria Young, and Hank Jackson. Our upcoming actor and actress are Glenn Reardon and Hannah Meadows. Our two with the most school spirit are our favorite twins, Lexi and Braxton Chase. The two people we chose for best dressed are Bailey Smith and Alex Dudash. Our life of the party is Jacob Stokes and Emma Swartz. The world's next Bill Gates are Sloane Yates and Kyle Ryan. Our masters of music are Bailey Keiko and Frankie Tincher. Our high school sweethearts are Mason Cooper and Rachel Lewis. Our next Plura athletes are Matt Morgan and Samara Gibson. The most funny kids on campus are Cole Stewart and Janaza Upchurch.
Man, I should have won best comedian, yo.
Well, you're not even funny. How does it feel to not be nominated for anything your senior year?
You're not even a senior, so you can't even talk. You're still parking the junior parking lot, junior.
Well, you're not graduating early, so you're still stuck with me for the whole year, senior.
Let's go check out the early graduates.
All I had to do to get early graduation was fill out an application and turn it into Ms. Palmer, which is my counselor.
So I did early graduation for college so I could go to it in the fall.
I'm graduating early because I have a job opportunity that I want to go after.
I wanted to graduate early to go to college after high school.
High school is just, it's good, but it's not the place for me.
The thing I suggest for other people is if you want to go to college and start early, you should graduate early.
You want to graduate early? Do it. Make the decision for you and not for anybody else.
They get out of school early? Man, I wish I could just get out of here earlier.
Yeah, I might be a senior, but I'm stuck here too.
We don't have to worry about the SATs anymore.
Yeah, words are hard, just like the SAT.
Let's go see what this week word is.
It's time for the SAT Word of the Week. This week's word is effervescence. That's E-F-F-E-R-V-E-S-C-E.
So I'm here with
Alexis, Faith.
And the SAT Word of the Week is effervescence. You know what I mean?
I think it means giving a lot of effort.
Doing more than you should.
Where did they go? You guys just disappeared. What happened?
Maybe to be, like, happy.
To put effort into something.
Where'd they go? They were just here again. Where'd you guys go?
We were here the whole time.
Sound like hard work.
Like effort.
Where'd they go? They disappeared again. Where'd you guys go?
I was sitting here the whole time.
Oh my gosh. But the SAT word of the week really means like liveliness, joy, like Christmas time.
Oh dang.
Oh, I love the Christmas time.
Like being alive.
How do you get that? It's doing more than you should. Wow.
You were right.
That seems like a pretty complicated word for the holidays.
Yeah, I'm pretty effervescent about the holidays, especially Christmas.
Oh yeah, let's go to Stephen and Taylor to find more about it.
Good morning, pirates. This is Santa Claus, here with you on this cold December morning, opening presents with little Johnny. Man, I love Christmas. But did you know, not everybody celebrates Christmas. For instance... Get out of here! Scram, kid!
Many different religions celebrate different things throughout the holidays. For example, Buddhism celebrates Bodhi Day, Judaism celebrates Hanukkah, Paganism celebrates Winter Solstice, Atheism celebrates Decemberween, Islam celebrates Maulid, Hinduism celebrates Pancha Ganapti, and at last we have Christianity, which celebrates Christmas.
Hey, it's your boy Tiwu, coming at you live from the Pirate News Station, and I'm here to tell you why the many religions celebrate their holidays this time of the year. Let's start with Judaism. Judaism celebrates Hanukkah, but why do they celebrate Hanukkah? After the rebellion of the Seleucid monarchy, to gain their temple back, they need pure olive oil with the seal of a high priest for the menorah. But here's the crazy part. They only had enough to last one night, but it lasted 8 nights, which is just the right amount of time it takes to make more. That's the miracle part. So how do they celebrate it? Is it like Christmas? Well, they celebrate it by lighting candles, singing songs, reciting prayers, you know, playing, the kids like to play the traditional dreidel game that we've all heard of, you know, that song that goes, dreidel, 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 I made you out of clay, dreidel, 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 I don't remember the rest of the song. Nirvana is one of my favorite bands, that's why I like to celebrate the Buddhist holiday, Bodhi Day. More like this kind of Nirvana, you know, the true achievement of inner peace. That's why we like to celebrate Buddha's achievement of Nirvana on this day. How do the Buddhists celebrate it? Well, it's pretty simple. They're very relaxed, peaceful people. So they like to meditate, they like to pray, they like to chant, they like to study, and that's about it. Then there's the Wiccans, the Druids, you know, all the pagans that celebrate the winter solstice around this time of year. That's right. No, it's not a bunch of Game of Thrones junkies saying winter is coming. They're celebrating the shortening of nights and the lengthening of days. It's actually pretty nice to think about nature once in a while. They celebrate it by singing, dancing, festivals, feasting, spending time with family, and rituals, and even spellcraft. Then there's the Islamic people who celebrate Maulid. What's Maulid? This is a celebration of the birth of Muhammad, of course. You know, they celebrate the holiday fasting and singing and having decorations. It is, you know, it actually is quite relative to Christmas. The very rich and interesting Hinduism celebrates Pancha Ganapati. They honor Lord Ganesha, patron of arts, guardian of culture. They give offerings of fruits and sweets to Lord Ganesha, and they give gifts to children each day for 5 days. Not like the Western part of the world where we spend billions, or is it trillions, of money on gifts each Christmas. Why are we in debt? A lot of people say atheists don't celebrate anything around this time of year. They celebrate the more consumerism style of Christmas. You know, where you wake up and go down to the Christmas tree and Christmas morning, you open gifts. That's what it is, the time of giving. Today we have a very special guest with us. I'm here with... I'm a Christmas tree. So I think you're the best candidate to tell us what is the true meaning of Christmas. Why does everybody celebrate around the world?
Well, still, we'll have to put up trees like me and give gifts to everybody and celebrate Santa Claus.
You're wrong.
A lot of people in this materialistic, capitalist world we live in forgets the true meaning of Christmas. We're celebrating the birth of the prophet Jesus Christ. If you go way, way, way back before Christmas is what is now, we didn't have Christmas trees. We didn't have Santa Claus because commercialism hasn't existed for that long. Remember, there's more than just this short list of holidays. There's hundreds of religions, so there's tons of holidays all around the year. However you want to celebrate, have a happy holiday.
Hey, it's your boy Henrik coming at you live from the Pioneer News Station. And there's no way I'm gonna remember all those holidays. But let's go to some news that's gonna be relevant after the holidays with Zach, who's gonna tell us about the winners of the raffle of the ACT Prep Week.
Good morning, Pirates. I'm here to introduce the ACE and the ACT winners. We're about to surprise them. Watch out. Excuse me for interrupting you guys' class. I'm here to introduce the winner of the ACE and the ACT. It's Miss Betty. Anybody? You have won. How do you feel right now?
I feel good. I don't know.
High five. So I'm here with Betty Kiros. She just won ACE and SAT. Your gift is Davy Jones Locker gift certificate. How are you going to spend it?
I'm going to buy a hoodie.
Are you going to monogram it?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't have a middle name.
Hello, I'm looking for Adriana. She has won a 2017 prom ticket. So I'm here with Adriana Guerra. She has won the Acing the ACT. She just won 2017 prom ticket. How do you feel?
I feel excited. I'm happy.
How'd you put in the work?
I worked really hard and I made sure that I got to all the sessions to make sure I could try my best and do better on the ACT.
Now, who are you taking to the prom?
Myself.
Aw. Congratulations to both of the winners out there for Acing the ACT. Good luck out there, guys. Thanks for putting in the work.
Hey Pirates, thanks for watching and happy holidays. See you next time.
Do you like religion? Do you like holidays? Well, there's a bunch of religions and a bunch of holidays.
What are you doing?